an unknown Asus phone just revealed in China. New video and image renders just leaked for Moto X 2017 model. PM Narendra Modi just launched Bharat interface for mobile app for enhancing digital payments in India. Nokia TA-1000 just passed 3C certification in China. Hi, this is Shane and it's the first day of 2017. Happy New Year. And you are watching Insider Expert. An unannounced Asus smartphone just revealed in China with the name dubbed as X00GD. According to Tela certification, this device will come with Android 7.0 Nougat, which means that it will be the first device by Asus that will ship with Android Nougat out of the box. Apart from this, this device will come with a 4850 mAh battery and a 5.2 inch display with 720 by 1280 pixel resolution, which means that the phone will be having a stellar battery life. The X00GD will be powered by an unknown 1.5 GHz octa-core processor, and which will have three variants, one having 2 gigs of RAM and 16 gigs of internal storage, the other having 3 gigs of RAM, 32 GB of internal storage, and the final model will be having 4 gigs of RAM and 64 gigs of internal storage, and will be bearing a 13 megapixel camera with dual tone LED flash at the backside and having an 8 megapixel selfie shooter on the front. This device might be a member of the Asus Zenfone 4 family, which will be debuted in 2017. And as Asus has already announced that at CES 2017, it will come up with new line of handsets of the Zenfone 4 family. At the last day of 2016, we get the sweet test of a major leak that we never expected. The leaked images and videos of Moto X 2017 based on actual factory drawings. Looking at the leaked renders, it is assumed that the design of the device is quite similar to the current lineup of the Moto Z models, with a few key alternatives. One of the most obvious of that is the lack of pogo pins at the back of the device, which means that the device will no longer be supported by Moto Mods. Apart from this, you will get a 3.5 mm headphone jack and a old type micro USB charger, which also means that the device will not be a flagship one, rather than it will be a budget range device. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday has launched Bharat interface for money app, or in short BHIM app, in order to bring the USSD and UPI payment systems to one platform, which will push forward the current digital payment trends in India. The app released by National Payment Corporation of India supports fingerprint authentication for transactions, and currently it is only available on Android. Like most of the UPI apps, in this app also you will not require to store your money in e-wallets. And to start with, you will need to generate your UPI pin, and post that you have to select your phone number on the basis of which it will verify your bank accounts. You have to select your bank and then only you can make your transactions. The key difference is that it uses your mobile number as the identifier. Other UPI based payment systems use VPA, virtual payment address, while this app uses your phone number as an identifier, as a VPA. Now, talking about limitations, you can only make a per day transaction of rupees 20,000 only, and limiting to rupees 10,000 per transaction. Nokia's roadmap of 2017 reportedly consists of 5 different smartphones, with one of them being launched at MWC 2017. While Nokia D1C will be the first one, now a new mystery device from Nokia has just passed the 3C certification from China. Now, on a side note, the 3C means China Compulsory Certificate. In the 3C report, where the device is termed as TA-1000, will support normal charging, that is 5 volt by 2 ampere, and it will be LTE ready. The lack of fast charging means that it will be an entry-level smartphone or a budget-range smartphone. Apart from this, it is also revealed that the device will have a 5.5-inch screen with Snapdragon 200 series chipset with only 1 gig of RAM, and it will come with Android 7.0 Nougat. Now, this brings us to the question of the day, that with these kind of specs, can Nokia surpass or even compete with the smartphone giants like HTC, Samsung, Sony, Huawei or not? In my opinion, not at all, never. Because today even entry-level smartphones comes with better specs than this. But don't forget to write your opinion in the comment section below. If you have liked my video, then please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please do it to watch more awesome videos like this. Till then, bye.